සුබෝ ශිංකුල් මහරාජ කී ජය හෝ ජය සිතරාම් දැරිවෝතී ස්වාගතම වල්කම් මත්තු සූරියෝදැයි ඔතිෝ ශුලි පනශිව ජනක් මහරාජ ඇරිවෝටීස් නර බියටිෆල් මෝනිින් ඉතිසිය ඉන්දි රිපබ්ලික් ඔෆ් ට්‍රිනිඩාඩ් අන්තබේගෝ හවකන් වී අපයිදි තැනන්ස නි ටීචන්ස් ඔ සනාතන් හරම් එනෝ වැරි ඕන් ලයිස් සුදත් වී කල අබ්‍රයිට හකිය මෝෆල් ෆිලන් ලයිෆ් We can be the sunshines, the studio day, the sunrise in our very own lives. As their devotees, many, many devotees, from time to time when you meet, you know, when you go to the mandirs and so forth, people do come to you. They come to the pandits, they tell us of all the problems that they have. And so there are many people in their lives that have night time seemingly, and you need some sort of sunrise. And so you too can make yourself a sunrise for someone else. Make your day, your life, the way you live your life, that sunrise that you can uplift and brighten other people's life. These are the aims and objectives of Suryoday, dear devotees, with your Shri Panachiva Janak Maharaj. And this morning, very, very beautiful time in your Hindu calendars. When you look at your Hindu calendars, be guided by your Hindu calendars, dear devotees. The Sanatana Dharma Mahasabha, we put together these calendars and your panchang and so forth, you know, they're all there to guide you to know what auspicious day is coming up, what vrat is there, what way, what opportunity do I have this week, what opportunity do I have today to make my life a better life. That's why they are there. Please use them. Far too many times people buy them, they have them there, and you know it's only when you're in some sort of problems or you have something very, very urgent to do, you go and you check them out to see is today a good day. However, they're there to guide you in so many other things, dear devotees. So if you looked at your calendar, you would have seen on Tuesday gone, we would have started that Vat Savitri Vrat for married women. Yes, for married women would have started their Vat Savitri Vrat, that fast specifically for married women to help them, to give them the strength that they need to do the duties that they do. And by doing that, our topic for today, dear devotees, how can we ordinary human beings, you know, we tend to think of ourselves as only human beings, be extraordinary, not just ordinary, but how can we make ourselves extraordinary human beings? So this morning, dear devotees, we look at the lives of two ordinary persons who have made their lives such an extraordinary one that will remember them up until today. And Savitri Devi is one such devotee. She was a regular girl. She was a regular daughter. She was a regular wife. She was an ordinary daughter-in-law. And so all these relations, how did she make herself such a way so that we can remember her and even have a vrat named after her that our married woman can follow to become just like her? And so, dear devotees, to begin this morning, we remind you, and your Guruji did this katha on Monday, on Aradhana. And so he reminded you that in life, especially when we choose our life partners, we do not choose our life partners based on purely physical looks only. It may be a contributing factor. However, we must look at the inner beauty of someone and how they live their lives with others before we get into relationships, their devotees. And so therefore, Savitri Devi, she picked Satyavan. And Satyavan was a very, very noble character, their devotees. Now, there's a situation nowadays, you know, with so many ailments and so forth, that people tend to, even those who are suffering from those ailments, I tend to think that, you know, that if I have a terminal illness and my life is very short, that I should not have a life partner. And so they push others who really, really love and care for them, maybe their true soulmates, you know, away from them. Never getting that opportunity to get together. Here in this katha that you would have are familiar with, that Savitri Devi, even though knowingly that her husband was going to die in 1 year's time from their marriage, she said, "This is my choice, this is the sankalpa, this is the promise, I shall get married to him. I shall change that fate." She had that faith that she can change the fate of her husband. Their devotees. And so Savitri Devi, she got married. And when she got married, she did not go into a home where everything was, you know, very luxurious and she had a very comfortable life. No, their devotees. Her husband, she went in knowingly that he will die within 1 year. And as well, she had many hardships with her in-laws. Not trouble from her in-laws, but she had many extra duties that she had for her in-laws because they were blind and she had to take care of them. And so how did she do it? What got her through the day? Let us find out from our very first video there, devotees, that I'll share with you. Savitri Devi, how did she get through her day? How should you get through your day when you have all these obstacles in your way, all these modes of sadness that some people take and they dwell on, and it brings down their whole aura and their whole attitude towards life? Let us learn from Savitri Devi, dear devotees. Umapati Mahadev ki jai. Umapati Mahadev ki jai ho. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, swagatam and welcome back to Surya Day. In that very beautiful video, dear devotees, we saw that Savitri Devi, an ordinary person. Today's topic, how can we make ourselves or transform ourselves from ordinary people, ordinary persons, into an extraordinary person, one that will be remembered for many, many, many years to come, even long after we have left this mortal coil, dear devotees. And so Savitri Devi, even though she had so many hardships, as you saw in that video, how did she get through the day? She got through the day while doing her chores, while taking care of her sick husband, or her husband, while taking care of her sick in-laws, their devotees. She prayed, she ended her nights many times, as you saw there, you know, crying and offering a genuine prayer to Bhagwan. You see, their devotees, in that state, when sometimes you feel you are so at your lowest point, as long as you have perseverance and you hold on to Bhagwan, you trust, O Lord, I know that you know what is best. I trust in you. That vishwas, dear devotees, that trust that you have, and that shraddha, that faith that you have in Bhagwan through your bhakti, your love for him, miracles can happen, dear devotee. So when that time was near, and it was time that she knew that that day has come, 1 year from her marriage date, from her viva samskar, she followed her husband Satyavan into the forest. And when she followed him there, dear devotees, the time came when he had that, you know, headache, and he fell down, and she knew this is it. But to prepare herself for that day, she fasted for 3 days. So as we mentioned before, this vrat, it started on Tuesday gone, and it will end today. Today, dear devotees, is the final day for this vrat. Those pious married women who are observing this vrat for the benefit and wellness of their family life, their devotees, and strength and health of their husbands. This, their devotees, Savitri Devi, she fasted for 3 days. Very important. How did she make herself so very powerful? She prayed and she fasted. There are many people who, you know, even when they are going through their problems and the Baba prescribes to them, gives them their prescription that you should do X, Y, and Z vrat. This vrat will help you in your situation. Baba, you know, I can't fast. It's often the comments that you hear. I can't do without food. I need food. And you know, this is like the argument that Bhim had. Bhishma, Bhim, one of the Pandavas for this Nirjala Ekadashi, which passed on Sunday. And you know, he said, I can't fast. Tell me, what can I do? And because he couldn't fast for the other Ekadashis, like his other brothers and his mother and his wife and everyone else, it was prescribed that you have to do a very severe fast with not even water. Nirjala Ekadashi. That was on Sunday, go on, their devotees. So to make up for all the fasts that he would have missed out on, he had to do an even more severe fast. So when you have your opportunities to just fast away from salt or not eat anything from sunrise to sunset and so on, you take those opportunities, dear devotees. It will help you even health-wise and physically-wise. It will help you. But in this case, it purified Savitri Devi so very much for fasting for 3 days that when that time came and Yam Devta came to take the Atman of her dear Pati Dev, she was able to see Yam Devta. So you are very powerful. And as you know, the Katha, what transcribed, let us see in this next video, dear devotees, what happened when Yam Devta came for her husband. Prem Sabolo Shri Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai. Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai Ho. Jai Sitaram Devoti Swagatam. Welcome back to Surya Day, your Thursday morning programming here on radio and TV Jagrati with your Shri Panachivan Janak Maharaj. Their devotees, in that beautiful video, because Savitri Devi fasted, she transformed herself from an ordinary person into an extraordinary person. Because she did her duties without complaining, she transformed herself from an ordinary person to an extraordinary person. You see, dear devotees, this is called the Varan Ashram system. According to your stage in life and your status in life, you do your duties accordingly and you will be taken care of, dear devotees. All our scriptures, Srimad Bhagavad Gita tells us that, Ramayana Katha tells us that, all of them tell us that. Do your duties accordingly and duly, dear devotees. You make yourself from ordinary to extraordinary, dear devotees. An extraordinary person. Yes, extraordinary makes you extraordinary, not ordinary. And so she fasted, she purified herself that way. She was able to see Yam Devta. She was able to follow Yam Devta, as you saw in that video. And she made certain requests of him. In the end, we know she even outsmarted Yam Devta. And she got back her husband, dear devotees. Such is the power of that extraordinary person. Make yourself an extraordinary person, dear devotees. And so, we have spoken about Savitri Devi. Thus far, she has made herself from an ordinary woman into an extraordinary woman who we remember even up to today. And many other married women perform the Vat Savitri Vrat, which started on Tuesday and ends today. And dear devotees, you will look at your calendars, you will see that tomorrow is yet another ordinary person who made himself an extraordinary person who is remembered up until today as well. That is none other than Kabir Das Ji. Tomorrow is Kabir Das Jayanti. Yes, dear devotees, Kabir Das, to summarize, you know, he grew up, he was found, and he grew up in a Muslim home, dear devotees, but he got under the guidance of Shri Ramananji, Gurudev Ramananji. And Ramananji, he taught Kabir Das. And Kabir Das, he was so very extraordinary, dear devotees. Once, when his Guruji, Ramananji, when he was performing his Manas Puja behind a curtain, and all the other students, including Kabir Das Ji, they were behind that. Now, one day, in the Manas Puja of the Guruji, he made an error in the sequence of the puja, and he couldn't have gotten the mala on because he already put on the crown. And in his mind, from behind the curtain, Kabir Das came into his mind and said, Guruji, open the mala and put it on. And so dear devotees, the Guruji knew that he was not an ordinary person, he was an extraordinary person. And that love that he had, dear devotees, for Bhagwan, that love that he had for Sri Ram, he always chanted the name of Bhagwan Sri Ram. He made himself from an ordinary person into an extraordinary person by chanting the name of Bhagwan Sri Ram, dear devotees. And by chanting the name of Bhagwan Sri Ram, Kabir Das Ji, there was an evil king that tried to destroy him in many ways. He sent rogue elephants to trample upon him. He tried to burn him, and so many other things that he tried to do, dear devotees, and he was never ever successful in putting an end to the life of Kabir Das Ji. Because what did he do? He always chanted the name of Bhagwan Sri Ram. Dear devotees, chanting the name of Bhagwan, performing your vrats and your fasts, and doing your duties are all secrets. These are all secrets that we are sharing with you, how you can make yourself from an ordinary person into an extraordinary person, dear devotees. Someone who will be remembered long after you leave this mortal coil. So, let us enjoy in this video how Kabir Das, how he had that love for Sri Ram, how Sri Ram appeared to him, how Sri Ram spoke to him, how divine that relationship he had with Bhagwan Sri Ram, dear devotees. Let us enjoy in this video. Siyavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai. Yavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai Ho. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, Swagatam and welcome back to Suryoday, your Thursday morning programming here on radio and TV Jagrati with your Shri Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj. How beautiful, dear devotees. Today's topic, how can we make ourselves from an ordinary person into an extraordinary person, dear devotees. And the secret, three secrets we have shared thus far. Just like Savitri Devi, what she did, and what Kabir Das Ji, what he did. They fasted, they did their duties, and what else? They chanted the name, they always remembered Bhagwan. They had full bhakti for Lord, they had the love for the Lord, they had shraddha, faith in the Lord that he knows best, and they had vishwas, trust, oh Lord, you will take care of me. These are all secrets. If you apply in your own lives, I guarantee you, dear devotees, you will see a change in your life. You will have a much more positive attitude towards life, and all the negativities will soon disappear. Have that shraddha, and Vishwas the devotees and Surya devotees. As we leave you this morning, we wish each and every one of you Bhagwan's choicest blessings. Remember, learn from Savitri Devi and Sri Kabir Das. Remember, today is the last day for Vat Savitri Vrat, for those married women who will be visiting their peepal trees and doing their pujas and tying their strings, etc. Today is that day where you do your puja to Savitri Devi. And tomorrow, Kabir Das Jayanti. So many beautiful Kabir Das bhajans that we know and love. Enjoy them tomorrow, dear devotees. Learn from his sakis. So many beautiful teachings of spirituality he has, as he loves Bhagwan Sri Ram so very much. And so, dear devotees, this weekend is the finals for the Bahal Vikas. On Saturday we have the, you know, the small schools and the large schools, Group A, on Sunday. So we wish all our children all the best, especially my own children who are the El Rado North Hindu School, who will be participating in the Gita Shloks on Sunday morning. Bhagwan's choices, blessings to all of you. Go forward, be successful, there you go. So we pray. Om Astoma Sargamya Tamasoma Jyotirgamya Mrityorma Amritam Gamya. Om Shantihi Shantihi Shantihi.